In a battle between two of the most badass space protagonists of the late 2000s and early 2010s video games, who would win in a fight? The tormented engineer, who is responsible for stopping multiple outbreaks, or the leader of an unstoppable crew who took on the galaxy's biggest threat? Let's take a look at it. Most, if not all, the feats and gear for these two have been covered in my Who Is videos. For information on that, there will be links in the description and at the end of this video. Because these two carry more weapons than humanly possible and have access to an array of even more weapons, I've decided to have them battle using their default slash most iconic weapons. For each class that Shepard has, I will highlight some of the abilities he possesses. Adept. Arguably the most dangerous class in the Mass Effect series. The Adept is a biotic specialist with the following abilities. Warp. Weakens a person's armor and stops the healing process. Throw. A Mass Effect field is tossed and sends the person flying. Shockwave. Pretty much rock skipping using a Mass Effect field. Singularity. Dark energy is tossed at a person or multiple people and temporarily traps whoever is in the radius. Pull. Like the name implies, a person is taken off the ground. Pull can be combined with throw. Cluster grenade. Adepts do have a limited carrying capacity for weapons as they mostly use their biotics in combat. Vanguard. A biotic and combat specialist with the following abilities. Incendiary ammo. When equipped, every shot landed on an enemy will ignite the person on fire. Cryo ammo. Similar to incendiary ammo, except it freezes the person. Biotic charge. Shepard becomes an organic torpedo minus the explosion of his body. He hurls his body toward the enemy and pretty much sends him shooting through the air. Nova. Shepard jumps in the air and unleashes a blast of energy harming anyone in the immediate area. And because he's a biotic, he will also possess the following abilities that is also available to an adept, such as Shockwave and Pull. Vanguards have a higher weight class compared to an adept, but lower than a soldier. Sentinel. A tech and biotic specialist with the following abilities. Lift grenade. If a concussive blast was contained in the grenade. Tech armor. Armor added on top of the default shields that Shepard already has, increasing his durability. Overload. Weakened shields and synthetic enemies. Cryoblast. Shepard sends a beam of ice towards an enemy and freezes the person upon contact. And similar to the previous abilities discussed previously, Shepard will also have the following abilities. Warp and throw. Sentinel's weight capacity is equal to Vanguard's. Infiltrator. A tech and combat specialist with the following abilities. Disruptor ammo. Similar to incendiary and cryo, when activated and shots hit the target, an electric pulse is discharged and will weaken shields and stun the enemy. Incinerate. Similar to cryoblast, Shepard sends a beam of fire towards an enemy, igniting a fire upon contact. Tactical cloak. Shepard turns invisible and allows him to sneak up on the opponents. Sticky grenade. A fragmentation grenade that sticks to an opponent upon contact. Sabotage. Hacking into synthetics, turning them into temporary allies. Shepard will also have cryo ammo. Infiltrators have the same weight capacity as the Sentinel and Vanguard. Soldier. A combat specialist with the following abilities. Adrenaline Rush. The ability to slow down combat and fire on the target for a perfect shot. Concussive Shot. A high-powered round is fired at an enemy and stuns the person. Frag Grenade. A standard grenade that explodes and maims slash kills anyone in the blast radius. Additional abilities include Incendiary Ammo, Cryo Ammo, and Disruptor Ammo. Soldiers have the highest weight class, allowing them to carry multiple weapons in combat. Because, you know, they're combat specialists. Engineer. a tech expert with the following abilities. Combat drone. A drone used to stun opponents and draw fire towards it. Sentry turret. Essentially a combat drone that can fire back. Other abilities that's included with an engineer that has already been previously mentioned include incinerate, overload, cryoblast, and sabotage. Engineers along with adepts have the lowest level weight class available to them. As I have previously stated in my Isaac Clark Who Is video, Isaac possesses a stasis module that is used to temporarily slow down an object, a kinesis module used to grab an object and drop or throw it, and a rig used for a variety of purposes. Now, let's get into the rounds. Right off the bat, round one automatically goes to Commander Shepard. Isaac absolutely gets murdered by Commander Shepard as his biotic abilities are just over the top. There's like no way Isaac can counter that. If Isaac Clark were to encounter Commander Shepard or any biotic specialist, then he's pretty much crap out of luck. So with that being said, round one, Shepard wins 10 out of 10. Another victory for Commander Shepard, and nearly as easily as the previous round. While the incendiary and cryo rounds are a deadly combination, it is a matter of if the shots actually hit Isaac that matter. This is made up of Shepard's Nova, Charge, and Shockwave. Shepard wins this round as well. Shepard wins this round as Tactical Cloak, Incinerate, and Sticky Grenades provide a big help in securing his victory. Similar to how I mentioned in previous rounds, cryo ammo and disruptor ammo will depend mostly on if the shots land on Isaac. Sabotage won't do well against Isaac as he's not synthetic, but either way, bottom line, Shepard wins his round. Tech abilities like Overload aren't going to be so useful against Isaac as he's an organic being. Lift grenade can also pose a problem as Isaac can use his kinesis to pick up the grenade and throw a bright back at Shepard. Warp would work if Isaac had armor like in the Mass Effect world, but what saves the victory for Shepard is the cryoblast, throw, and tech armor. Upon impact, the cryoblast is able to freeze an opponent solid. Not with slight movements, but complete motionless freezing. One could argue that with tech armor, Isaac could just shoot the hell out of it. Well, yeah. He could. He's also susceptible to getting hit with cryoblast or throw and getting slaughtered in the process. So, yeah. Shepard wins his round. One of my favorite matchups when I thought of Commander Shepard versus Isaac. The only ability that I can see helping Shepard in this round is Concussive Blast. Adrenaline Rush? That sounds similar to Isaac facing the Twitcher. A simple blast of stasis will slow him down and it slides out. Frag grenades? As one may have used in Dead Space 3, he can just use his kinesis module to pick up the grenades and throw it right back at Commander Shepard. Even though a sticker grenade could be a better option, same rules apply. And the specialty ammos will depend on if Shepard lands the shot. Now it goes down to weapons. Now, because of the weapons that they're carrying, I can see Commander Shepard winning this. Though I will say that Isaac could win it because he has taken on opponents that carry weapons similar to what Commander Shepard carries. So, majority win goes to Commander Shepard. Hey, look it out. It's engineer versus engineer. This round, in my opinion, would go to Isaac. Not by much, but it will still go to Isaac. The only advantage I see with Shepard in this encounter is Cryoblast and Incinerate. Most of Shepard's tech abilities are better suited for synthetic beings. While Shepard does still have a fighting chance to win this round, I'd say Isaac edges out by the skin of his teeth. Overall, in the battle between two of the most iconic space protagonists in video game history, Shepard just outclasses Isaac in nearly every class. I've always been fascinated by this battle because Commander Shepard and Isaac Clark are two of my favorite space protagonists since they have been a big part of my video gaming history. But after researching and playing other classes besides Soldier in Mass Effect, this battle is far from close than what I originally thought. So the winner in 5 of 6 rounds goes to Commander Shepard. On a quick side note, in my opinion, Isaac is honestly one of the most forgotten video game characters in recent memory due to how well Dead Space 3 did and with this latest release being in 2013. He's not the only one, but he's one of them. It still doesn't change the fact that he's a legend. But you know what else it doesn't change as well? It also doesn't change the fact that we still don't know what happened to him at the end of Dead Space Awakened. Come to think of it, Dead Space 3 came out in 2013. Mass Effect 3 came out in 2012. The most recent release of Mass Effect came in the underrated game of Mass Effect Andromeda. Fight me. Not only that, but the Mass Effect Legendary Edition came out in 2021. Luckily for us, though, we are getting a Dead Space remastered in the not-too-distant future. And I, for one, am excited for it. With that being said, let me know your thoughts on Commander Shepard versus Isaac Clarke. Do you think if there had been different weapons, the outcome would have been different? Imagine a sniper rifle battle. Or even a pulse rifle versus an M7 Lancer. Leave your thoughts in the comments section. Thank you for watching this video. Take care of yourself and enjoy the rest of your day.